We're out here on the savannah today, and I think I just saw with my own eyes a real-life programmer still using technologies from 2021. These programmers are hardly seen nowadays. They're so rare to find, stuck back in the past of the technologies. Let's go see if we can catch it.
I'm too cool. I will never, ever let AI help me with programming. I will be stuck in the past forever. All right, you do not want to be a techie that is stuck in the past like that person was. And because of that, today we are going to talk about the top 5 ChatGPT plugins. Pause there. If you haven't, if you've been living under a rock, which I'm sure none of you have been, you need to know that ChatGPT recently announced that plugins are now available to anyone with the Subscription Plus membership. And of course, I got sucked into paying for the Subscription Plus membership. So I'm going to take you through the top 5 plugins that will help you code better, be more productive, all with your fingertips. As a quick side note, one thing that has come up is various companies not allowing certain AI tools to be used at work. These tools that I am listing, these plugins that I am listing, they are a great way to utilize to learn how to code, whether you are starting out your coding journey or maybe you are further along, you're learning a new language, building a project or business, or also to maybe you're not a coder and you want to just focus on the productivity aspect, understanding what some technical tools are doing, these are for you as well. Companies may be banning or having limits around the usage of AI tools right now, but what I know will happen, or what I see will happen in the near future, is they will come out with their own version of tools for this AI or for these AI tools that these employees can use. It will not be that employees are not allowed to use AI tools in the near future. It's very impractical that way. And in turn, what will happen is AI will merge very closely with different roles and will work alongside them. All right, that's enough. That's enough of that intro. Let's get into it. I feel like we need some light in here. That's better. That's better, right? A little bit more light. It's a really rainy day here. The first plugin that I would do a disservice to this video if I didn't list and go through now that I have access to it is Code Interpreter. I recently did a video covering Code Interpreter. I wanted to share with you what some other people are building with it. This is probably for me the biggest plugin that's going to change a lot of things. This is going to significantly help data analysts, data scientists, it's going to help developers. So essentially this plugin has the power to help you write Python code, not help, it will write Python code for you. So what's the difference between this and ChatGPT? When you prompt ChatGPT, write a Python script for me, it will spit it out for you, right? But what Code Interpreter will do is it will allow ChatGPT to write and run the code. So it's a huge difference. You've seen a lot, or I've seen a lot of use cases where someone inputs an Excel sheet and then it outputs a form of data visualization for that. All right, Code Interpreter it's acting up a little bit for me here. So instead, I'm gonna share with you on screen here some more examples of things that people have used with Code Interpreter. It's crazy, like look at these things. And it's one of those things that it's really good with visualizing data, but also to helping you write better code. This next one might be, no, I'm not gonna say that again. I feel like for every tool, every plugin, I keep on saying, this is the best one, but it's because they all are so helpful. I really took time to research and find the best ones for you, which is Craftful. So what exactly is Craftful? Well, it solves the problem that when you're going ahead to start building a product, maybe you have an app idea, a business idea, it can be very overwhelming. You're like, where do I start with this? What steps do I know to take? And Craftful will essentially walk you through each step. It refers to itself as the product development coach, and it pretty much is. So you can use it to ask questions about building a product, source the industry's best practices, and have it provide feedback on the product you're working on. So especially if you are a freelance developer or wanting to get into freelance development, this tool I think would be so helpful for you to, when as you get stuck or you're not certain about the next steps, as you're starting out your freelancing career, you can rely on this to help guide you. All right, so what I did here with Craftful is I literally just put in, share with me the best way to improve retention of keeping users on a website. So this is pretty generic, but depending on the product you're building, you can get specific, and it will literally share with you sources and outline the steps needed to keep users on a website. This is super handy too as a value add-on when you are freelancing. Think of all the things you can tell your client, hey, by the way, I really took these extra steps to ensure that users stay on your website. The next one is called Prompt Perfect, and this is essentially what it says it does. You can tell it what kind of prompt you are looking to give. Maybe you're not a prompt expert. I mean, there's already so many job listings for prompt engineers. This is a real skill set that people are developing, and it isn't something that people naturally have. Just as when you are learning how to code, you have to learn how to Google, they say, now you're learning how to prompt. So with this prompt plugin, you essentially can write something as simple as, say, summarize what the Python script X, Y, and Z should be able to do, right? And when you use Prompt Perfect, it will rewrite your prompt to be longer, more detailed, so you can get a very specific answer from AI. This I put off for so long. I thought, oh, this is kind of cool, but is it really that helpful? When I started playing around with it, especially in the technical space, whether you are a technical person or even if you are not and you just want to understand some technical concepts, which by the way, nowadays, who doesn't, with tech literally taking over every industry or immersing itself in every industry. And it's a really great way to be able to learn very fast because you are learning the way that works best for you by having things explained in that way. Next on the list is called Show Me, and it does exactly that. It creates diagrams for you in a simple visual way. So this is perfect if you are looking to learn something that's very complex, technical, more theory-based as well. It will actually spit out a diagram of what you are looking for. And I've actually seen examples of people using this when they are using Mermaid.js, inputting some of the prompts or code for that, and then it outputting it in a very nice format. And obviously Mermaid.js creates Obviously Mermaid.js can visualize data as well, but this just reformats everything. But I think the main thing it can do here is really show you in a visual way what you are learning in graph format. And this is something if you start talking about system design, it's very interesting, or how systems are built, it gets pretty fascinating. Let me show you. All right, for Show Me, what I did was I go create a diagram for me of Netflix system design, but you can think you can do this really with anything. I just wanted to see what it would produce, and it was super accurate. You can see here user, request, load balancer, etc. And then I also really like about this is that it explains a bit about the process as well down below, and you can also edit the diagram, which is really cool too. So you can think of how much this could come in handy when you are writing documentation or when you are just trying to learn something new and visualize it. And the fifth one, the last one I want to talk to you about is called Ambition. And this is for all my job seekers out there or people who are interested in seeing what other, maybe you're not fully job hunting, but you're curious about it. And it is called Ambition. And Ambition, did I ever say it's called Ambition? I did. I need more coffee. Ambition essentially lets you really customize the job search so you can get really specific results. Nowadays, I find there are so many different job postings and job communities online that can get very overwhelming as to what is good quality, what is junk. This will actually combine all of these job postings into one place, curate it so it's very specific to you. So it's much more efficient and you can apply for jobs at a much quicker rate, quality jobs. All right, this is using the plugin Ambition. So you can see here, I said, find for me software engineering jobs that have 1 year experience required. Tell me where you are looking for these jobs. And you can see here, the plugin is enabled. I'm gonna say I'm looking for these jobs in, let's say, Toronto. And now you can see it's using Ambition to provide us with these results. It's pretty cool. All right, as this is generating on screen, something else that you could really get specific with is the pay bracket you're looking for, different if it's remote, different things like that. This is pretty generic prompt I gave it, but you can get very specific with it, which is very cool. Also too, I really like that it links it out to these job postings. So this is so handy. All right, it's great with all these tools, but at the end of the day, if you don't have the right skill set or not building or learning with the right skill set to utilize these tools or build with these tools, what good is it? It's like giving someone, what is that old saying? Giving someone a hammer and nail who doesn't know how to do construct, that's not the saying, no, it's not. All right, to take away from that bad joke, check out this t-shirt I changed for you. Eat, sleep, compute. What more do you need in life? All right, let's go through some courses that I've been having my eye on, some that I've actually taken, not only building with ChatGPT, but also to utilizing OpenAI's API. I've seen so many job postings for this skill set intertwined with developer roles or intertwined with product management roles. It's kind of feeling like it's all coming together right now. And having these courses, these certifications on your resume is so key, especially nowadays with AI sifting through resumes, being able to include these keywords on it, game changer. The first course that I want to talk about is called ChatGPT Masterclass. Build solutions and apps with ChatGPT. Now, what this course will cover is not only will you be able to build full business applications with OpenAI's API and ChatGPT's AI, but also to integrating ChatGPT into several business platforms, such as Outlook, Teams, Excel. So you're not only learning how to build with this technology, but also to implement it into other technologies. Other things that stand out about this course, here are some of the key things I always look for when I'm checking out if I want to commit to taking a course. One is the time. How long is this course? Sometimes long courses, if they're broken up in the right way, can be very beneficial. But for me personally, I know my learning style, I don't like to spend 50 hours on a course. I like to kind of know that I can spend a weekend on it and move forward. And this course is 6.5 hours, so it's a perfect, I mean, you can complete it in a weekend, 3 hours Saturday morning, 3 hours Sunday morning, and then you have this to put on your resume, which is amazing. Also too, I look at the ratings. I love that Udemy always is very transparent about the ratings. So not only does it get a 4.5, but it's out of over 1,300 ratings. So that means 1,300 people came in here, and overall it still has a 4.5, which I think is pretty cool. Also too, I'm gonna link all these courses down below. It'll be very easy for you to access and check out. All right, the next one on the list that I really wanna go through is the complete guide to ChatGPT and OpenAI's API. So similar title to the last one, but you do learn different skill sets in this one. What I like about this one is it also focuses on Midjourney, which I mean is an incredible AI tool that you see so many amazing projects coming out of. And for this course, I like how it's broken down into different sections. So not only are you getting, you're kind of getting the best of both worlds, meaning you are getting some development courses in some development sessions in this course, but you're also getting things such as how to build automated AI tools, how to focus on prompt engineering. It kind of covers a wide range of skill sets and things you can do with AI, which I really like because then the course isn't limiting you to here is how you as a developer can build with these tools, but also to kind of flexing some other skill sets. As developers, as techies, whatever role you are in, you need to be open to continuing to evolve and being aware of other roles and other tools out there to use, which this course dives into, is a great way to really get that experience. Next one is one that I am actually in the midst of taking because if you know me, you know I have been obsessed with Python as of recent meaning like the last while, really, actually, it's not really recent. And being able to use Python skills, Python programming with ChatGPT is honestly a game changer. It is, I feel like when ChatGPT came out and I started using Python with ChatGPT to build faster and more efficiently, my creativity just blew up. I got so excited. I felt like, okay, what business opportunity do I see? What app do I want to create? There's so many things now. Because when you are developing and you are one person, whether you're freelancing or building some projects on the side, outside of your day job, I think one of the biggest frustrations why so many of us always stop working on side projects is because it takes so long. Or you get stuck on a bug that you just cannot crack for so long. You're just like, it's not worth it. And I really found with using these tools that it really helps resolve that. And this course here, I've been really enjoying so far, being able to really merge the Python skills and knowledge with ChatGPT. And also it's 3 hours long. I think I'm 1.5 hours in. I've kind of just been puttering around with it, but I highly recommend this course as well. All right, the last one I wanna talk about is for everyone in any role, but anyone who just wants to have a side hustle or make some extra income, which I think is all of us at this point. And it's called ChatGPT and Midjourney. So it's 23 ways of earning money with AI. And I was kind of skeptical about this course at first. I said, is there really going to be any differentiators that I don't know about or that the public doesn't know about? But they give some really valuable tips throughout it. It is at a 4.7, it's at one of the highest rated ChatGPT courses on Udemy, and it has over almost 2,000 students thus far. It's a newly released course. It was just updated a few days ago, actually, which I really love as well. They're staying on top of AI that's moving so quickly. And it really goes through different ways that you can use ChatGPT to make money, things that you wouldn't have thought about, from copywriting, email marketing, video scripts, sale funnels, website content. And I think this, again, is just another way to really, even if you are more on the technical side, integrate some of these skill sets with that while you are building to be able to generate income from what you are working on. All right, we have gone through a lot. I hope you found this video very valuable and helpful. As a reminder, I linked all the courses down below, so make sure to go check them out. If you've taken some of them, let me know in the comments. Let me know other questions you have in the comments. Basically, I do my absolute best in the comments to respond to all the comments. So leave your comments. Hit that subscribe button. I really appreciate all your support and love, and any suggestions you have, leave down below. All right, I think I need coffee. Maybe I've had too much coffee. Anyway, bye everyone.